Hi, I'm Elena from Alpha Korean Class. Are you ready for the most important and basic Korean particle test? Then, let's get started! Are you still confused 은느니가 with? Do you want to check if you know all the Korean basic particles? This time, I prepared Korean particle quizzes so that you don't miss out on the basic grammar. Then let's break it down. Do you want to remember 100 basic Korean verbs? There are so many verbs you studied, but do you keep forgetting them? You think you should review it, but honestly, you don't want to, do you? Then you should join this challenge. It's the Korean Writing Challenge for 100 days for free. For more information, check the link in the description box below. Alright, the first sentence is easy one. 안녕하세요. 제 이름은 서현실입니다. 안녕하세요. 제 이름은 서현실입니다. Or 안녕하세요. 제 이름이 서현실입니다. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright, here 제 이름은 서현실입니다 is correct. Why? Because there is 안녕하세요. Grammatically, 은 or 이 can be exchangeable almost every situation. But when we introduce ourselves, first time, I say my name with 은는 particle. 저는 서현실입니다. 제 이름은 서현실입니다. Alright? When you practice the new particle or new expressions, then think about the situations. Next. 하루 종일 아무것도 못 먹었더니 너무 배는 고파요. What is it? 너무 배는 고파요. Or 너무 배가 고파요. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Okay. This time, 너무 배가 고파요. Mostly 이가 represent what is the subject of the sentence. But 이가 also very often used with adjective. So when you express your emotions and describe something, remember 이가 is more used. 자, next one is this. 할아버지 혼자 지내신 지 5년이 넘으셨어요. 할아버지께서 혼자 지내신 지 5년이 넘으셨어요. Or 할아버지가 혼자 지내신 지 5년이 넘으셨어요. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. This time you can use both. Okay. Because 께서 is honorific form of 가. It depends on the context of the situations. So if the mood is more like casual mood, then you can say 가 할아버지가 혼자 지내신 지 5년이 넘으셨어요. But if you think that situation is more formal and you have to more be careful, then pick the right honorific particle. Alright, let's move on to the next. 저는 벌써 한 시간째 친구 기다리고 있어요. Okay, which one is correct? 친구를 기다리고 있어요. 친구를 기다리고 있어요. 3, 2, 1. Alright, this time, 친구를 기다리고 있어요. Whenever you learn Korean particles, maybe you see the 이가 or 은는 or 을을. If there is a final consonant just before the object particle, then you have to use 을. But like this, 친구 has no final consonant, so 친구를 기다리고 있어요 is alright. KTX를 타면 서울역, 부산역, 2시간 30분이 걸려요. Alright. 서울역부터 부산역까지. Or 서울역부터 부산역으로. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. The answer is 서울역부터 부산역까지. So here, the option 부터 was the same and it means the start point. But what about the destination? 부산역 is destinations and you have to use 까지. Actually, 으로 can be used for destinations. If I ask you like 어디 가세요? Then you can say 부산역으로 가요 or 부산역까지 가요. That's okay. But in this case, why 부터까지 is correct. 부터까지, it's like one pair of couple. The next one is this. 저녁마다 공원 산책하는 사람들이 많아요. 공원에서 산책하는 사람들이 많아요. Or 공원에 산책하는 사람들이 많아요. Which particle is correct? 3, 2, 1. All right, it is 공원에서 산책하는 사람들이 많아요. All right, 에서 and a can be used just after the place noun, right? But when you use 에서, it mostly used with active verb like play, 놀아요, or run, 뛰어요. Where? In these situations, you have to use 에서 just after the place noun. And this place is kind of background of that moving. That activity, all right? But A is more like just one point. So, where are you going? 집에 가요. I'm going to my home. Also, A is used after the time, the certain time. 몇 시에 만날까요? What time shall we meet? 2시에 만나요. Let's meet at 2 o'clock. And the next one is this. 이번 여름에 어디 휴가를 갈 계획이세요? 어디로 휴가를 갈 계획이세요? Or 어디에 휴가를 갈 계획이세요? 3, 2, 1. Which one is correct? Alright. This time, both are correct. 어디로 휴가를 갈 계획? 어디에 휴가를 갈 계획이세요? That's because these two particles, 에 and 로, express the destinations and also the direction that you are heading on. And this time, 어디에 휴가를 갈 계획이세요? Then I can answer, 부산에 휴가를 갈 계획이에요. Or 제주도로 갈 계획이에요. 자, next one. 이 수업이 한국어를 공부하는 학생들, 도움이 되었으면 좋겠어요. 학생들한테 도움이 되었으면 좋겠어요. Or 학생들에게 도움이 되었으면 좋겠어요. 3, 2, 1. Alright. We can use both. 학생들한테 or 학생들에게 is okay. Because this 에게 and 한테 in Korean is like two or four same meanings. 에게 is used the written form as spoken form. But the 한테 is mostly used in the spoken form. That's the only one. And the next sentence is 헬레나 선생님 한국어를 배웠어요. 헬레나 선생님한테 한국어를 배웠어요. Or 헬레나 선생님이랑 한국어를 배웠어요. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. All right. This time, 헬레나 선생님한테 한국어를 배웠어요. Is correct. Just we learned 한테 means to someone, right? But in this time, 한테 has another meaning. When this particle is used with learn, 배우다, or get, 얻다, or receive, 받다, this kind of verb, then we use this particle like from or by. So maybe the other person can ask you like, 누구한테 한국어 배웠어요? Then you can say, 헬레나 선생님한테 한국어를 배웠어요. Or 알파코리안에서 한국어를 배웠어요. You can use 한테 or 에서 both. Go to the next sentence. 누나는 친구들 휴가를 보낼 거래. 누나는 친구들이랑 휴가를 보낼 거래. 친구들하고 휴가를 보낼 거래. 친구들과 여름 휴가를 보낼 거래. That is everything. All right, it was a tricky one, but I believe there is a people who know the answer, right? Because this three has the same meaning and with. We more use 이랑 and 하고 in the speaking language, but 과 is used only, not only, but mostly in the written form. So when you use 과 or 와 in the conversation, it sounds a little bit awkward. 자, next one. 이 빵은 유기농 밀가루와 당근 만들었어요. 밀가루와 당근으로 만들었어요. 밀가루와 당근을 만들었어요. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. 밀가루와 당근으로 만들었어요. 으로 or 로 can be used just after the place noun, like 부산으로 가요, 서울로 가요, yeah, destination. But also it is used when you say the ingredient or the materials. So it is like by in English. So made by wood, 나무로 만들어진. By carrot, 당근으로 만들었어요. 엄마, 내 친구는 주말에 롯데월드에 간대. 롯데월드에 가고 싶어. 나만 롯데월드에 가고 싶어. Or 나도 롯데월드에 가고 싶어. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. So here, 나도 롯데월드에 가고 싶어 is correct. Because 도 means also or to. So I also want to go to the Lotte World, right? But when you use 만 here, it's the context is weird because 만 means only. So if you want to go alone, then you can say 나만 롯데 월드에 가고 싶어. Then what about your friend? I don't care. I don't want to go with her. 자, 다른 사람들은 다 쉬고 있는데 왜 너 혼자 일하고 있어? 왜 너 혼자만 일하고 있어? 왜 너 혼자의 일하고 있어? 3, 2, 1. Alright. So this time, 왜 너 혼자만 일하고 있어? It's easy, right? I just explained before, 만 means only. So if you just don't care about others, if you are just working alone, it is 만. Next sentence is, 그 사람 성격을 한마디로 말하기는 어려워. 만날 때마다 성격이 달라 보이거든. 그 사람의 성격을 한마디로 말하기는 어려워. Or 그 사람의 성격을 한마디로 말하기는 어려워. Which particle is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. The answer is 의. When you need possessive particle, we use 의. So his personality is 그 사람의 성격. But it's a little bit tricky when you just listen my voice without this spelling. 에 also right. Yeah, in a conversation, if you say 그 사람의 성격을, it's okay. Because 의 can be pronounced four ways, alright? So if you're really curious about it, then I recommend to watch my other videos about 의, how to pronounce 의 videos. But here, the spelling is important, right? So we have to use 의, okay? Then next one. 작년, 올해가 훨씬 더운 것 같아. 작년처럼 올해가 훨씬 더운 것 같아. 작년보다 올해가 훨씬 더운 것 같아. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. 작년보다 훨씬 더운 것 같아. 보다 means than. So, if you think it's much more hotter than last summer, then of course we have to use 보다, than. Alright, the next sentence is 한국어 가르치는 게 쉬워 보이죠? 그런데 생각 쉽지가 않아요. 생각처럼 쉽지가 않아요. Or 생각보다 쉽지가 않아요. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Alright. That is 생각처럼 쉽지가 않아요. 생각처럼 쉽지가 않아요. It's like it's not easy as like you think. And 생각보다 쉽지가 않아요 means it's not easy than you thought. There is no big different meanings, so maybe you can use both. This is the last sentence. Let's go. 이번 주말에는 산 바다로 놀러 가자. 이번 주말에는 산이나 바다로 놀러 가자. Or 산하고 바다로 놀러 가자. Which one is correct? 3, 2, 1. Boom! It is 산 이나 바다로 놀러 가자 because 이나 is or. Yeah, let's go to the mountain or sea this weekend. Yeah, not mountain and sea, all right? Today we learn about the essential Korean particles through the quizzes. Please let me know in the comments what was your score and can you make a sentence using these particles? Join in the Korean writing challenges. You can check the description box below to join in and you can practice how to make Korean sentences for 100 days. You can do it because I'm with you. Alright, now smash the like button and subscribe this channel if you didn't. And thank you for learning Korean with me. Then I will see you next Sunday. 그럼 다음 영상에서 만나요. 안녕!